Hi, I'm Dave Sjeklocha. I'm the Operations Manager of Animal Health and Welfare for Cattle Empire.
Hi, I'm Tera Barnhardt, and I'm the Coordinator of Animal Health and Welfare here at Cattle Empire.
We're here today because we are going to put some cattle through our newest processing barn. We've put a lot of effort into developing processing facilities that are good for our cattle, and this is our newest processing barn. It utilizes what we call the bud box system, and we're going to go through the system so everyone can see how a bud box works.
Processing facilities are used when we bring cattle to the feed yard for the first time, and so they are ran through this facility when they arrive here so that we can give them their vaccinations. We can give them some parasiticals to get rid of any, you know, to deworm them. We can give them their identification and any other processing protocol that we outline as veterinarians for our employees. And so the animals are only brought through here when they first arrive at the yard, and then they're taken to their home pen shortly after that.
So if you'll follow us, we'll take you through our new processing barn and show you how the cattle are going to be put through the system, so we can keep our stress on our cattle at a minimum and handle them as gently as possible. Okay, so the cattle will be held in this pen before we take them into the processing barn. The workers will come out here and grab just a few at a time and take them into the processing barn. So from here we'll walk toward the processing barn. We built this facility with this gate purposefully to be at an angle so the cattle would not have a square corner to go into. So that provides an angle, so as the cattle come out of the pen, there's a nice gentle flow around the corner here. And of course this gate will be open. We'll bring cattle into the bud box. And this is what we call the bud box. It's just a fairly good sized pen that the cattle will come into. The goal is to have them go down to the far end of the bud box. So come on, step on in. Once the cattle are in the bud box, we'll shut this gate. And so the goal is that the cattle will come in, they'll go down to this end while the worker shuts the gate. And then when they go to this end, they'll pause and realize there's not a way out, so they'll be looking for another way out. So the workers should come up along this fence and just put a little bit of pressure on them, and the cattle will go down that wall and come up against the gate we just closed, and they will flow down here, come up against this gate, and then go up this alleyway. This is a Daniel's alleyway. It's adjustable. These sides adjust in, and this top rail can adjust up and down, so we can literally put calves, 300 pound calves or 1400 pound calves, through this facility and adjust it to the size of that animal.
So once the cattle enter the alleyway, they will come in here and the workers will make sure that they're moving smoothly through this part of the processing area. The cattle will walk up to the chute, where the chute is designed for human and animal safety. And so we want to make sure that we can restrain the animal so that the animal feels safe and so that the humans can work with the animal in a safe manner. And so the animals will enter the chute one by one, and they'll be, this is called a squeeze chute, and so it will put a little bit of pressure on the animal to hold them still. This part of the chute actually holds their neck so that we can put the ear tags in them or administer any vaccinations that we need to do. And then this is all opened up and the animals are allowed to exit the chute and go to a pen full of hay and water.
This is a hydraulic squeeze chute. It's made by a company called Silencer. It has lots of contact points here that have basically a shock absorber on them, so it's not loud when you close it. It doesn't clang, it doesn't bang. One of the many misconceptions about hydraulic chutes is that we can just put lots of pressure on a calf with the hydraulics. But the fact is, there's hydraulic pressure relief valves on these squeeze chutes that when a certain amount of pressure is reached, the relief valve kicks in and doesn't allow any more pressure to be applied to the calf. So it does hold the calf still, so we can work on him and do the procedures we need to do, but it's safer for the calf and safer for the people to have him held still. Another unique detail that we have with this chute, most of our other hydraulic chutes actually raise up above the floor, which makes it a little tougher for cattle flow, because the calves actually have to step up to be in the chute. It's only a 4 or 5 inch step, but it's still a step. And so with this chute, we've actually recessed it into the floor, so the calves come from this alleyway. It's a smooth, level transition into the squeeze chute. That's going to help cattle flow. And then it also, the recess also helps us to keep the area clean, because any manure the calf may drop will not land on the main floor. It'll drop into this pit area that's drained with water.
You might have noticed that a lot of our concrete has these deep grooves built into it, and that just gives the cattle a better and safer footing. Sometimes when we're working cattle, it gets pretty messy in here and there can be mud and things like that. And so this just makes sure that they have something safe and stable for them to walk on, so that they're not slipping or falling. Animal welfare and animal care is a big priority of ours. And so when you're designing a facility like this, you have to take all of those things into consideration. This is one of the computers that is in the new barn, and all of our cattle, when they are processed, go through our computer system, and it allows us to manage them more closely from a health standpoint and a feeding standpoint. And so one thing at the processing barn that the computer allows us to do is we can scan the tags using these readers right here that are on the chute. And it scans the tag that we put into the animal, and then it pops up on the computer screen. All of that animal's individual information is there. We can record a weight at the time of arrival, and then we can monitor that animal's weight throughout the feeding period. And so I think part of our job, the computer is a pretty important part of it that helps us manage the animals accurately and make sure that we're taking good care of them.